Hello, everyone, and welcome to this edition of the Real Estate Academy podcast. The Real Estate Academy provides personalized education and training for realtors. Today, we're going to check in with a lady by the name of Neda Omidi. Neda works in the Preconstruction Division at Royal LePage, Your Community Realty, and Royal LePage Connect Realty. Neda has over 10 years' experience of working in the preconstruction sector of the real estate industry, and she's going to share a little bit of her insights with us today in terms of what that whole division of real estate looks like and how you can leverage it in your business. We're going to get on a call with Neda right now.
Hi, Neda.
Hi, Michelle. How are you?
I'm great. Thank you. And thank you so much for taking time to take this podcast call for me.
My pleasure.
So, Neda, we've been, at the Academy, we talk about a lot of things, and I know you do a lot of work with our realtors, pertaining to a pre-construction division and in terms of educating them. And so today, what we were hoping for was maybe just to get into a bit of a conversation around, you know, what that pre-construction industry looks like, you know, for our new realtors out there or realtors who have not ever been involved in that sector of the industry. What are sort of some of the things that, they should know? How can they leverage that in their business? And maybe just a quick overview of developers' launches and projects and at what stage in the game they should be a part of all of that. How does that sound?
Sounds great. Let's do it.
Perfect. So maybe we'll just go right into why don't you share with us a little bit about your experience in the pre-construction sector, where you came from, what you're sort of seeing as maybe a trend?
Sure. Yeah, of course. So I was licensed back in 2005, and the company where I registered my license with was actually owned by a developer. So from the very get-go, I was introduced into the world of pre-construction and had an opportunity to work closely with the developer in terms of the resale of his brand new product that potentially wasn't sold at the time of the launch, as well as working at the sales office level and selling his product. And throughout the years, I continued working in pre-construction as a buyer's agent. Eventually, I decided to work very closely with developers and have worked with companies like, or developers like Minto, as well as Pemberton Group, ever since I've joined Royal LePage, Your Community, and have done basically both ends of the world of pre-construction, being a sales agent on site, as well as representing buyers and bringing them into the sales office.
Right. You've got a pretty good understanding then of sort of that well-rounded approach to what that whole industry looks like.
Absolutely. I've been on both ends.
You have, yeah. Now, more recently, you have been doing a lot of work not only with developers and the brokerage, but also in educating our realtors on, you know, how to get into this sector of the industry and what that all looks like. So maybe you can share a little bit with us. Maybe let's just sort of start from the beginning in terms of if I'm a realtor who has never done any pre-construction before, where do I start? What are some of the things that I should be on the lookout for, and how can I start getting involved?
Sure, yes. The pre-construction has become a really huge part of the real estate industry, and a lot of buyers now see value in buying pre-construction. And so as realtors, we find ourselves in a situation where we might not be familiar with, but we'll have to very quickly become familiar with the world of pre-construction. And in order to do that, I would say then start small. You know, you don't want to get yourself overwhelmed by how large the industry is, but start small, ask around, ask your colleagues, And start with developers that potentially have been in the industry for a longer period of time. What I would probably do is talk to myself, of course, and I'm happy to help any one of our realtors with where to begin and how to make it. But go to the sales offices that are open and learn the lingo. Have the site agent walk you through their product and tell you what, you know, aspects of why their product is special and what their incentives are and what the prices are. And there are websites that we can utilize to familiarize ourselves
with the product that is available out there and all the developments, because there's just so many. So I would concentrate in one area and start learning about the different developments that are available currently, and slowly learning the trend and the price per square footage, for example, for that particular area. And then little by little, you'll get a little bit more experience. You'll understand the floor plan and what the meaning of these drawings are, and what certain boxes mean, and what certain shorthand terminologies, for example, mean. And take it from there. Then we can potentially learn a little bit once you get a client here and there, and are accompany them through that process of buying and signing. Then you become familiar with what the agreement of purchase and sale of a builder will look like, because it is quite different than that resale agreement of purchase and sale that we've been, you know, working with as a resale agent.
Right.
It's going to be a different product altogether, and you'll eventually become more familiar with it as time passes and the more deals one person does. But so you want to familiarize yourself with the product, then start advertising. And I would probably reach out to my existing clientele, because I might have done resale with them all these years, but it's a good opportunity to reach out to them and let them know.
Right. Well, and because they don't normally come, you know, most times clients don't realize the capacity or the, you know, the broad spectrum of services that a realtor
Absolutely.
Is able to provide. And
Exactly.
so they might just naively be driving, you know, along down on a Saturday and see a site, you know, a sales center, and walk in and not realize
Exactly.
that could be something that you could help them with.
Absolutely. Absolutely. A lot of the members of the general public will walk into a sales office, and once you tell them, oh, I could have helped you, oh, I didn't know that you do that, and I wasn't sure if you know that's something that you can assist me with as well. But, you know, as realtors, we can bring a lot of value to our purchasers, because if I bring a buyer to a sales office, I could potentially advise them that within that 10-day cooling off period, you want to have a lawyer review it, and I could introduce you to a lawyer who is well-versed in the world of pre-construction, because not every real estate lawyer is familiar with that pre-construction
right.
end of the business, and might, you know, kill the deal as opposed to protect your clients as best as you can.
Right, so thinking that they're doing good and dissecting it, but not really fully understanding that these are probably standard in that whole, you know, that whole world,
exactly.
and then cause the, you know, the buyer to maybe rethink or back
Absolutely.
Away. So yeah, completely.
Pulling that agreement apart so much that there's no point of going back. And
right, it almost sounds like, you know, a realtor getting into this is almost sounds like they're starting over, because you do have to learn all the language. So if we go back to, you know, the licensing days, and when you had to get licensed to become a realtor, as you're going through that, you're learning the language, you're learning the terminology, you're learning about the contracts. And so you're kind of relearning all of that, but that's specific to pre-construction.
That's right. I mean, obviously there are common grounds. For example, that 10-day cooling off period, which is also called rescission period, could also be considered a conditional period. And some people do refer to it as a conditional period. But
mm-hmm.
as a resale agent, if I walk into a sales office and they tell me, okay, your client has their 10-day rescission period is up, this Friday, that I might not necessarily make that connection that this is their conditional period.
Right.
So definitely there is new language to learn in this process.
Right. So now maybe we can talk a little bit about, and you can share with us, we hear a whole bunch of terms being thrown out there in terms of VIP and platinum and, you know, all of these fancy words for how developers launch their projects. Can you give us just a bit of an overview of what exactly that means and how that looks and what, you know, why should that even matter to a realtor?
Sure, of course. So majority of the developers out there participate with us, the realtors, because we are the biggest source of their sales, if you will. So we bring the buyers to them. And so they look out for us, and in many cases you'll find that their marketing material will actually say brokers protected. There are a handful of products out there that do not necessarily pay commission to realtors to sell their products, and freehold detached properties is a good example of that, because they, for the longest time, they were moving so well that they didn't need to cooperate with the realtors and pay commission to sell their product. But in most cases, condominium apartments and townhouses do cooperate with realtors. And the way they will then decide to launch a product, or basically their marketing strategy, is to bring the product first and foremost to their friends and family, the circle of their friends and family. And that is the first group of people that essentially gets to see the floor plans and sees the price list of this particular development and has an opportunity to purchase. From that point on, and now keep in mind, during that friends and family period, they do not pay commission. So I, as a realtor, might be invited to a friends and family event just because I'm friends with the developer. But that doesn't necessarily mean I can sell them, period, and earn commission. Just are geared towards their friends and family, keeping in mind that the developer doesn't have to pay commission. So the incentive will be a particular incentive for that event. Once that friends and family stage has passed, the developer will open the floor to the realtors that have previously worked very closely with this developer and have performed well and sold a lot of units for this developer. And they call them, you know, different builders have different terminologies for this group of realtors. Some call them elite realtors. Some call them the golden circle. But majority of the developers out there refer to this group of realtors as their platinum agents. Mm-hmm. And so they'll have their platinum launch where they will provide pricing and floor plans to the platinum agents and will cooperate with these platinum agents to assist them in selling to their clientele. And the obviously pay commission. The incentive package might be changed by this point to reflect that commission that they are paying out. But in most cases, the price is either the same as their friends and family launch or just slightly higher. And that period could last, depending on the interest, obviously, anywhere between a week, 10 days, 2 weeks, to probably a month, depending on how much interest there is from the platinum round.
Once that's really the first opportunity then that, you know, our consumers or our clients have the chance to buy in to a particular project.
Absolutely, absolutely. An individual who is not working with a platinum agent will not be allowed into the sales office. They will guard the doors really well. Someone will stand at the door with probably a list of their platinum realtors and will basically ask for a business card. If you're partner of a realtor who's platinum, even, and your name isn't on their list, they will not allow you inside. So they really basically guard that platinum relationship really well.
And I guess it's important for them to do that because, you know, the integrity of keeping it available only to platinum and creating that marketing hype is going to be contingent on, you know, them being strict in that, you know, or restrictive rather in that sense in terms of who they allow in.
100%. Now, keep in mind, some developers, their list of platinum realtors might be 300 long. Because they find everyone, you know, they want to bring all the realtors that have worked with them in the past through the doors and look after them. But some developers might have a list that's only 20 people.
And that's all based on past performance.
Exactly, 100%. And the size, the sheer size of the project as well. One particular property that we dealt with last year was the Icona condominiums, for example. They were launching 5 towers within a day or two period of time, so they wanted to make sure they can sell all the units, 1,000-plus units. And so they were able to cater them to 300 platinum realtors.
Right.
But if a project is only 120 units, then they will not want to disappoint too many people, and so their platinum list then will shrink to maybe 20 or 30 or maximum 50 people in total.
Right. So then what happens after that platinum launch?
Sure. Once that platinum launch and period is done, then they will open it up to the general population of realtors. Some developers refer to it as their VIP round, but in most cases, that's just referred to the general realtor population. And so at this point, still the registrants, someone who does not have a realtor is not allowed to go in and purchase unless they are accompanied by a realtor.
At this stage as well, the prices will be increased slightly, and the incentive package might be different. So what they were offering to the platinum realtors might not necessarily be offered to the VIP or the general population of the real estate agents out there. And the availability obviously will not be the same. So
right.
if the building is by this point at 50% sold, then you know the general realtor population only has access to 50% of the building.
And so I guess there'd even be times where they may sell out during platinum and there's nothing available coming VIP.
And we are seeing that more and more. And nowadays, where these developments and the pre-construction world has become so popular, and it's a way for people, it's a more affordable way, if you will, for people to become property owners.
Right.
And we are seeing that, yes, absolutely, during the platinum launch, within a two-week period of time, the entire building has sold with the exception of maybe 10 units in total. From the original 300.
Yeah. Units. So then it's important then for realtors to, you know, try and get in on that platinum level. So knowing that, what advice would you give, or what sort of ways can a realtor, you know, work to achieve a platinum status within a development project?
So one thing that I always recommend to our realtors is use your connections and your network of realtors, your colleagues out there. So if I, as a realtor, do not have platinum access to a project, and a colleague, for example, from another Royal LePage office or a RE/MAX office does have that access, I want to look good to my clients and let them know that I can deliver and bring them into the pre-construction world. And so I will reach out to my network of realtors out there and find out who does have access. Because if my buyer can't get in through me, I know for a fact that they will try to get in through someone who does have access.
So why not be like that person?
Absolutely. I want to keep them for me. I want to be loyal to them. I want them to be loyal to me and continue that relationship. And so in some cases, if I reach out to an outside brokerage or an outside broker or agent who does have access, that agent will hold a percentage of the commission. For example, if the total commission is 4%, that agent might choose to keep 1.5%. Sometimes if the project is hot enough, 2% of the commission, and only pass on to me 2% or 2.5%, whatever the balance of the commission is. But I would rather give up a percentage of the commission and basically deliver to my buyer as opposed to lose a buyer in the interim. So,
right.
you know, don't dismiss your connections with outside brokerages and outside realtors as a way to get into platinum. Another way, a great way to build a relationship with developers in order to become a platinum on their list is to go to their sites that are not sold out, but they're sitting on inventory, and do events. Hold a weekend event. Send flyers out for that developer. And they will love you for it. It's free advertising for that developer on a site that potentially the buzz has died down at, and maybe they're not getting that, you know, people knocking down their door, trying to get in units, and think that, oh, the building is exhausted, the buzz has died down. But the builder might be actually sitting on 20% of inventory or 30% of inventory, which is still a nice range of units. And I can come now comfortably at my own pace without having to, you know, be
battle the crowd
exactly through the crowds to get in. Then send out flyers, do an e-blast to my database, and offer some sort of incentive. In some case, in one particular case, a real estate agent came into the sales office and wanted to do a promo where they did some very plain flyers back and front, you know, half a page size, and sent it to the immediate neighborhood of this particular development. And they were offering a free iPad with the firm purchase of a unit at this development.
Right.
And the number of people that walked in requesting and inquiring about this iPad. Where's my iPad? I'm here to get my iPad. And they actually, on a site that was somewhat dormant and sitting on 25% of their inventory, they were able to sell 25 units in one weekend. That particular agent was able to sell 25 units without having to fight the crowds, like we said. And
right.
At 4% per unit commission, I mean, you do the math, he made a killing that weekend.
Exactly. So there's definitely money to be made and business to be created in this sector. And so I guess what we're hearing from you is there is a lot of opportunity out there, and it really just is about realtors, you know, learning how to navigate this part of the real estate world and getting creative with how they can start bringing their client base in and how they can get their name out there to the developers.
Absolutely. Because that wow. agent who sold the 25 units in one weekend was not a platinum agent and was not allowed to come into that sales office during their platinum launch. But
right.
this way, he built a name with the developer, and the next project the developer was launching, this realtor was invited to as a platinum agent, and that's how he got his foot through the door.
Well, good for them. Well, Neda, thank you so much for taking the time to talk with us today and give us a little bit more insight into this world. And I'll give you, a little minute here if you want to put in a plug for any of your realtors that you do work with or any projects that you're currently working with.
Thank you so much for that opportunity. Yes. So we, at Royal LePage Community, we do work very closely with a lot of developers and perform as their site agents, if you will, as their inside sales team. And a few of the projects that we're working with and have been very successful are go-to condominiums by Pemberton Group at Major Mac and Dufferin area, if I just plug that in. Another one is Stateview. We work very closely with Stateview, and they have been delivering amazing product to our realtors and our buyers time and time again. And they're working on a project. They've launched a project, townhouse project at Elgin Mills and Leslie area in Richmond Hill called Edge Townhouses, Edge Town. There's another product, freehold townhouse product by Casavia Homes at the corner of Keel and Major Mac. And all of these, if you Google the name, they're called Noble Square Townhouses, and the website will pop up and you can register for more information if you will.
Perfect. Or they can contact one of the amazing realtors at Royal LePage, your community realty, and Royal LePage Connect Realty, and allow them to, help get them the product that they're looking for.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Perfect. Well, Neda, thank you so much,
You're welcome.
We look forward to talking with you again soon.
It was great chatting with you, and thanks for the opportunity.
Thanks, Neda. Take care.
You too.
Bye-bye.